Move on up again, let me start by saying, that's some mucho extensions. How come she ain't got a crick in her neck? The stars of our movie today are the bully from the Princess Diaries and Shazam! Play! Our story begins with Flynn Rider talking about how he almost died and then it don't, the end. You see, back in the day, the sun melted and a drop fell down and birthed the magic flower that this old hag used to do some magic to turn her back into a young hag by singing,
Flower gleaming, glistening, tell me if you're listening. I don't wanna look like a turkey, make my boobies firm and perky, firm and perky.
And then over here in this random kingdom, this king and queen are just trying to have a baby, but Mother Nature gotta be a bit. So they run to get the sun melted and drop fell down magic flower and chop the damn thing down, make some golden melted sun tea, and squeeze out that little golden head muffin. And the king is so happy about it, he ain't even questioning whether Mrs. King been creeping. They just proceed with this little flying lantern party. And then the evil bit sneaks in and sings to the baby until her hair be gleaming and glistening, and then tries to take a look at that magic sh**, but psych, bit! So she kidnaps the napping kid. So Rapunzel don't question that her mama look old and then she brush her hair and look young again. And now every year on Rapunzel's birthday, they have a big flying lantern party. Now Rapunzel is locked in this here doorless tower and adopts a chameleon from the local chameleon rescue, who keeps her company while she finishes her chores, does some Cirque du Soleil, and watches the big lantern parties on her birthday, all while knowing it's her birthday because Evil Bit is very bad at being Evil Bit. She moves the child like a couple of miles away from the kingdom where she can see everything. Never thinking folks might get curious about a doorless tower in the middle of the damn sticks. So basically, she's in quarantine. Except she's way more productive than I was. Am. She's like the quarantine version of me I wish I could be. Most of us with nowhere to go just be lying around proud of ourselves if we put on some pants that ain't got any elastic and a drawstring. And now this Steven bit parkouring across the kingdom, but I'm unsure why he's teamed up with Buff Beavis and Butthead. Then he Mission Impossible into the castle and he grabs Rapunzel's tiara and RUNNOFTs. Back at the doorless tower in the damn sticks, Mama's home and yells,
Rapunzel, let down your hair.
And Rapunzel just flings her wig out the window and pulls Mama up to her deluxe apartment in the sky. And I'm just trying to figure out why, with all this physical activity and heavy lifting, Rapunzel ain't built like Ronda Rousey. But all Rapunzel wanna do is blow this hot dog stand. She's like, look, Mama, while I was bored, I channeled my inner Galileo, and I want to go see the big lantern party live. And Mama's like,
you want to go outside? You get to come in.
And then she sings a song about,
skip the drama, stay with Mama.
Now here comes Flynn and his partners in crime doing his damnedest to flee from the royal army. Somehow he ends up on this stubborn ass. Then he ends up off this stubborn ass. Then they both go out on a limb, and then they almost die. And then they don't. Okay, pause. Mama keeps insisting they need to put assholes on these animals. How would you like to be the guy at a movie studio that gets put on asshole duty? Would you want to go through years of animation art school just to be told you're the one who designs the assholes for Disney animals? Oh, that's great, because we got a new movie about dogs and we need a unique asshole for every one of them. It's called 101 Dalmatian Assholes. Imagine the title on his resume. Asshole guy. The bigger the asshole, the bigger the paycheck. Okay, proceed. So for the next several minutes, Flynn is doing his damnedest to hide from the Buff Beavis and Butthead, the royal guard, and the horse he rode in on. So he scales the wall of the doorless tower and the damn sticks, and Rapunzel give him a straight concussion. And now she crushing. Yeah. Then she does what any sane person would do. She hides the body. And then 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 she hides the body. Then she finds her own tiara, but she don't know it's her own tiara. And she does what any sane person would do. She hides the loot. So she tries to tell her mama she wants to leave the doorless tower in the damn sticks. Again. And her mama tells her no. Again. So Rapunzel tells her mama she wants some special paints that will only take her mama 3 whole days to get. And she goes to get her the paints that will take her 3 whole days because Evil Bit is very bad at being Evil Bit. So while she's gone, Rapunzel releases the captive. But he's still kind of almost deceased, so her pet chameleon has a little fun. So they have a little discussion about how he wants her to let him go, but how she wants to go see the big live lantern party. And she says if he takes her and brings her back, she promises him she'll give him back his goodie bag. And then she starts singing, and then she keeps singing. But Big Booby Mama finds the horse he rode in on. So Mama is mad as hell. But lucky for her, the sunlight comes in the window just enough to reveal the loot, because this make-believe. Then Flynn takes Rapunzel out on her first date, and to avoid, as he says, ruffians and thugs, he takes her to a sleazy bar full of ruffians and thugs. Then all these broke somebodies be trying to collect the reward on dad ass. Then Rapunzel's like, look, I need that bit right there to help me get to the big live lantern show. So would you please have a heart, even if y'all are mad as hell that you look like a bunch of extras from How to Train Your Dragon? And I'm just thinking about how bad it would be to look under your bed late at night and see that Porky Pig looking bit. So they break out into a really annoying song about having dreams, Skip. Then the Royal Army men bust in the joint and they escape somehow. But the Royal Army all over their asses. And Rapunzel goes Tarzan fronting twice. And now they've sabotaged the damn dam. So they're trapped in this cave and about to die. And Flynn admits his real name is Eugene Fitzherbert. And Rapunzel tells him about her sun melted and drop fell down magic flower hair, which she subsequently uses to light the way to an exit, find an exit, and heal Flynn's boo-boo. But Evil Bit makes a deal with Flynn's former partners.
You give me the tiara, and I'll help you get the blonde and the beefcake.
So now the Royal Army, Buff Beavis and Butthead, and very bad at being Evil Bit, are all on their asses. Then the two people who always argue start to like each other. But Evil Bit is like,
oh honey, that man don't love you. All he wants is that little tiny blonde ass in his bed so he can hit it and quit it.
Oh Lord Jesus, not this ass again. But Rapunzel is the horse whisperer. So at the Random Kingdom, Rapunzel gets her hair done, sees herself as a baby but don't know it's her, and does that dance from the Titanic. Finally, she gets to see the big lantern party, live from Random Kingdom. Then they sing a long song and Rapunzel gives Mr. Fitzherbert the tiara, and then they almost smooch until Mr. Fitzherbert sees Buff Beavis and Butthead. And instead of just explaining the situation, it gets all weird because men in new relationships sometimes be doing stupid shit. So they strap that dinghy to a dinghy and get knocked out by Big Mama. Well, Belle Biv DeVoe did try to warn y'all to never trust a big butt and a smile. Then Rapunzel thinks that Krusty Bit was right and that Flynn didn't love her and really just wanted that booty. Then Flynn gets captured with the crown. And then, execution for theft? I guess losing your child would make you a little cold-hearted in the lawmaking department. So then Rapunzel go home, and then Flynn busts out of jail with the help of them singing DreamWorks rejects and dad ass. And then Evil Bit helps Flynn up the Dolus Tower in the damn sticks. Next thing you know, Evil Bit stabs Flynn. And Rapunzel begs Evil Bit to let her heal him. And then it cuts off her hair. And the chameleon becomes the unsung hero, and Evil Bit is like,
oh shit!
And then Rapunzel got no more magic hair, but her tears heal him, which is really convenient because folks usually cry a lot when somebody gets dead. Can her snot heal you? Because I don't want no life renewing boogies. Then they go back to the Random Kingdom where King Daddy and Queen Mama reunite with their long lost child and forgive the man who stole her crown and let him marry her. Well, I guess with her being gone so long, they'll let her have whatever she wants to keep her happy. We're just so glad to have you back. You can bring along your trashy boyfriend, the end. All right, Muffins, I'm gonna keep it real with you. I need some help keeping this channel alive. In August, I gained 5 patrons, and I lost 7. That's how lucky your favorite muffin is. If you would please help me keep this channel going by contributing a few dollars. Or a lot of dollars, I won't mind. Please, I just don't want to go to art school and become Disney's asshole guy. For Movies Explained For, I'm Jeb. Asshole guy a dire. Damn, my neck hurts just watching this movie. Mama, can you give me a haircut?